This is 8-Bit Days a Week, and we're gonna play Jumping Flash on the PlayStation Classic. Now, here's a game I never played as well back when the PlayStation was new. This was one of the first games released, I believe, even in Japan. So I know it's basically a 3D platformer, but that's about all I know. Let's see how it goes in today's environment. Maybe it's still playable and fun. But yeah, like I said, never played it before, I have no idea. So it's a first person, I wouldn't say shooter, of course. Huh, maybe it is a first person shooter. Do I know where to go? Reminds me of the in certain sections of Star Fox where the R-Wing transforms into a walking robot thing. This one's just completely in the first person. The graphics is just outdated as expected. It's too grainy. But the gameplay is so far not bad. If I could just figure out what to do. I suppose there's a goal here. Because it's not your. It doesn't seem to be your typical get from one point to another. Or maybe it is, let's see. Exit. Okay. You need to collect something. Jet pods. How do I jump higher though? Platform. That's cool. Okay, one more to go. I wish it spins faster there. Oh, there it is. And there seems to be something over here. I couldn't reach it. How do I reach that? Okay, there must be some other platform I could go to first. Is there like a look? Holding R1 seems to enable me to look around. It's probably something important, of course. At least the frame rate is not terrible. It's a PAL game, meaning it's probably slower than it should be. But since I don't have actual experience to the NTSC version, it doesn't look all that bad to me. Doesn't feel that bad. So that's a plus for this game. But since I have minimal experience with it, I don't know if there's actual performance issues regarding frame drops. Or if it's behaving as expected, because unlike, say, Ridge Racer, given my experience with it, I immediately noticed frame drops there. So there seems to be really something with the emulator being used, not being optimized. Two left. One. Where's the other one? That's too far away. I'll just go to this one first. And now, how do I get to the last one? An egg. Got it.
Danger. All right.
Not bad. I have no idea what's the status of this series, like if it's considered essential or a cult classic, something like that. But from what I'm experiencing so far, it's actually not bad. It's actually a fun game. And I'm beginning to wonder why isn't this more well known? I mean, I don't regularly see it on, you know, like top 10 lists of essential PlayStation games. It's probably because it's an early title, so maybe not a lot has experienced it. I know there's a sequel to this, that's about it.
Danger!
I can't believe I'm having more fun with this one, more so than the other well-known series, like GTA, or even Persona. I guess it goes to show what kind of games people could enjoy. It really differs from one to another. So I'd say this is a good inclusion to the PlayStation Classic. It's an early title. It shows, I guess, how it all began. It may not be the best. Of course, there are a lot of better games that probably more deserving to be included than this one. That much I know. But for what we have right now, it's not bad. People could give this a chance. Anyway, that's it for Jumping Flash. You're watching 8-Bit Days a Week. And please do hit the subscribe, put your comments, hit the like. And thanks for watching.